My name is Stanislaw Robert Luberda, and this is lesson 9 of 10 lessons in my Introduction to Premiere Pro class. In this lesson, we're going to be talking all about title layers in Adobe Premiere Pro and some things you can and can't really do with them. Before we get started, I just want to point out you've probably seen some of my other lessons where, let's say at the beginning here, I've got this text coming in here, or even where I have my name coming in, my Adobe Certified Instructor. Those aren't technically created in Adobe Premiere Pro. Although I'm working in Adobe Premiere Pro, those particular graphics are created in Motion and After Effects. So you'll notice that they can do a lot of movement. There's a lot of graphical things happening. We actually have three-dimensional space where this is kind of pushing in. I've got some reflections in here. Those are things that you can't easily do in Adobe Premiere Pro. If we just want to put together some title layers that we can kind of manipulate and fade in and fade off, we can absolutely do that. So let's go ahead and get started. To create titles in Adobe Premiere Pro, we're going to come down to our new item. And in our new item column, you'll notice that I have a few different fields here, and we've touched on one or two of these. And the one that we want to talk about today is our title layer. As soon as I click on my title layer, it gives me the same kind of dialog box that we've kind of had before. How big is it going to be? What is our time base? What's our pixel aspect ratio? And what is the name of this? I'm going to call this one Thailand Title. And I'm going to click OK. What's different about this particular layer is when I click on OK, it brings me into a new panel that we haven't seen before. So this panel here is our title panel. You'll notice that we have a preview image of the frame that we're on, and that we can see right up here. So this is our show background video. This is actually pretty important, and I'm glad that they've included this, because in the past, what would happen is you would just have something like this. And what if I spent a lot of time creating a title here? And I decided, you know, this blue font's gonna look really, really nice. And I wanna put on my scene, and I put it on there, and it kinda gets lost in there. It just doesn't look very good. Having this show background video is very useful because I can see exactly how my title is going to look in shape and in size and in coloring with my video. I actually have a time code that I can scroll to view how it's gonna look across different areas of my video. And so I might wanna work with this. So now that we know a little bit about that, I'm going to expand this here just so that we're focusing on this. And let's talk about the title panel. We have just a few main panels inside of this layer, but let's talk about them. Starting with the top left corner here, we have our controls that are very similar if you've ever used any kind of layout or typography software. We've got our arrow tool, we've got a rotate tool, we've got our text type tool, and text area tool. The difference between the text tool and the type area tool are how we're gonna lay things out. If I pick my type tool, I can just click somewhere and start typing. And it lets me just continually make more and more titles. If I take my type area tool, I can specify a specific box for me to type things out. And if my text goes outside of that box, it's not going to show up. I can see that I've got this little plus sign here. So if you're familiar with, say, InDesign, this is going to look very similar. My text is all still there, but I can't see it all. So if I take my selection tool and I select this, I can move on quickly to the top here and change the size of my font. You'll notice that in this area here, I've got some different buttons. I've got my fonts, I've got my font families, bold, italic, underline, etc. Let's just get rid of this and actually make some nice type. You'll notice that in our title window, we have our safe frames. Typically, we want our titles, anything with words, to be with inside this inner frame. This is our title safe area. And any action that's going to happen in our videos are going to be within this action safe area. So just be aware of that. I'm going to put some text right here. It says, my trip to Thailand. Hit my selection tool. And I'm going to work with this font just a little bit more. And let's talk about how we can do that. You'll notice to the far right, I have my title properties. So this is where I can transform. I can change where it is in my screen here. And I can also navigate my same fonts and font families. I do like that it gives me a nice little preview here so I can see what my font's going to look like. Let's say maybe I want to pick with something like Futura here. And I can choose my different font family, maybe a extra bold. And I can work with the sizing, leading, kerning, tracking, etc. Moving further down, we have some different fill and stroke types. So notice my color right now is blue. I can change this to a black, and that's going to change that. And I also have shadows, color, opacity, and even a background. So if I wanted to make a background here of a linear gradient, and maybe we'll make that opacity like that, and we'll change this too much further down here. I've now just created a little background for my title. I'm going to change this shadow here just a little bit and maybe not spread it out so far. So I'll probably want to finesse this just a little bit more, but let's come down here and talk about what we have down here as our title styles. Think of title styles as presets for your different titles. So for example, this one right here is with an OCR font, and it is the regular font family and has some different colorings attached to it already. Notice my background does not change. So if I really work with one of my titles here, I can actually set it up and save it as a preset. So let's say, for example, I wanted to do that with this one here. I want to just change this guy, make that a little darker there, drop that opacity, and work with that just a little bit. And I'm going to move that down right here. And let's change that fill type to something nice and white. Now, if I wanted to save this, I can come right to my title styles. And I can save this as a new style. And I can say custom style. And at the very bottom here, it's created a new one based on the name I've given it. And if I click it, right now nothing happens. But it lets me quickly and easily save different fonts and colors. So if I have specific spec sheets of specific text that I want to save and use over and over again, I can do that very quickly and easily. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna close this right now. We're gonna come back to this in a minute, but I'm gonna close this right now. And you'll notice that in my project, I have a new layer, and this is my Thailand title layer. I can drag this right into my sequence. So I've plopped this right here, and you'll notice that it just comes right on. And the reason for that is it works just like any other kind of video or photo layer. The background is transparent, and so it's just showing me that. So if I wanted this to fade in, I can apply my default transformations like we did in the other lesson. I'll need to render that first. Let's go ahead and take a look at that as that's fading in. Okay, so we've made our first title here. What if I want to create a second title? Well, I have this title in here, so you're probably thinking, well, I could probably just drag this one, and I'm going to type in the name of this place, which is Fengnanbe, and I'm going to double click it, and it's going to take me back into my title layer. And in here, and hopefully I spelled that right. I apologize if I didn't. And I'm going to go ahead and change that. So now it's Fengnanbe. However, if I go back to my first title, that's now changed too. Because I've changed the original. This isn't a separate title, even though there's two instances of it. They're both referencing this same title. So I'm going to undo that. And what we have to do is make a title based on this title. So here's my challenge. What if I love the way that this was actually set up and I just want to change out the text? I want it to have the same font, and all I want to do is change out the actual words. Well, I'm going to double click this Thailand title. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a button up here that's new title based on current title. What this button is going to do is basically copy everything here and make it its own new original. So this time I'm going to go ahead and call it Fengnanbe. And now I'm inside this new title, but it looks identical to the last one because it is. What I have to do now is go ahead and change this text and close this out. And you'll notice now I have two separate titles in here. So I have my Thailand title, my trip to Thailand. And then I also have my Fengnanbe. So if I drag this over in here, I can right click this. And there's my one title. And then here's my second one fading in. There's a couple caveats I want to talk about using these titles. Let's say I'm doing a production that's going to be across 30 different projects. I'm going to be using this title and this kind of a background here, and I'm going to be using this over and over again for different projects. Currently, this title only lives within this one project. So if I went to Premiere Pro, new project, and start a new one, there's no way I can access this title because it only exists within this one project. What I can do though is create a template. And by clicking this button here, I can actually create my current title as a template. And so I can just say Feng Na Bei, and now I can hit okay. Now at any time I can go into my templates and all my different ones that I've created will show up in here. And I can just hit okay, and that would actually create this. There's one more cool thing that we can actually do with titles. What I can do is I can click on my title here that I want to export or share with somebody, go to File, Export, and I have Title. And this is going to make a special kind of file in Adobe Premiere Pro. It's called a title designer title, and you can see it has the suffix of .prtl, so a Premiere title. And I'm going to call this Feng Na Bei, and we're going to hit Save. You will both need to have that same font installed, otherwise it will just replace it with the default. So be aware of that, is that it is a live title, meaning that it is not flat. Someone can open this back up and change out the words. We have two other kinds of titles that we can make that are very, very common when we're doing production. One would be a rolling and one would be a crawling title. So let's talk about those. I'm gonna make a end title right here, and I'm just gonna go back to new item, title. I'm gonna call this my end crawl. And I'm gonna make a big old box here using our shape tools. And I'm gonna make that maybe black with a 44% opacity just so I can give myself a nice title here. And the reason why that keeps popping up is that is the top named font there. That is not the last font. It was just the top one that I have in my layer stack. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick one of our layer styles that we just created. And I'm gonna format this just a little bit by centering it. And I'm gonna just create one more here. We're gonna make that a little bit smaller. By the way, this panel here and this panel are identical. This just gives me a short breakdown of everything. So I'm just gonna do that. And now what I'm gonna do is click this button here and take a look at my roll crawl options. We have our still, which is what it is now, or my rolling credit. And I can start it off screen and end it off screen. And we'll click OK and close that out. Here's my end crawl. And notice this is now a movie file. Currently, I have this end crawl that is just a few seconds long. If I retime this by dragging it out, it will automatically figure out how fast it needs to go. So it's really excellent if I'm retiming something to create these titles using the end crawl or the rolling credit, so that way I don't have to think about the actual timing of animating things like this. Now this only works with title layers, so be aware of that. I'm gonna just shorten that back down to a few seconds here. And if I play that back, you can see there it goes. If I double click that again, let's take a look at the other option I have here. If I change that, instead of a roll, I'm gonna go ahead and crawl left. And I still want it to start off screen and end off screen, and we'll hit okay. And now this will crawl from right to left. So as you can see, there are a few things that you can do to add some motion to our individual title layers and some different ways we can create them. Incidentally, there's one more thing I want to talk about here, and that's if we have graphics that we want to embed into our title. It's very common to have logos inside of our titles here. And if I right click anywhere, I can actually import some different graphics. So I'm going to go ahead and import my watermark here, and there it is. And I'm going to go ahead and bring that in. And notice I can resize it and work with it just like I could anywhere else. So if I just place this maybe right in through here. And I'll go ahead and close that out. Now that is embedded within that title. So that's it as far as titles in Adobe Premiere. Just be aware that if you want to reuse titles in different projects, you do need to make it a title template by clicking on this button here and importing your current title as a template. Or if someone exports a title out for you, so for example here, we've got my Feng Na Bay, and we exported that using our file export title, we can actually import that using the same dialog. So I can either just drag it in using it like a normal import, or I can import it right here, import file as template. And there it is. So hopefully that explains the way titles work in Adobe Premiere Pro. In our next lesson, we're going to be finishing up and we're going to be talking all about exporting out of Premiere Pro. So how do we get this into a flat movie that we can share on the web, put onto YouTube, Vimeo, or FTP sites? My name is Stanislaw Robert Luberda. This has been lesson 9 of 10 in my free Adobe Premiere Pro introduction class. Hopefully you found that useful. Thanks for watching.